Hello, book nerds. Welcome to Bookshelf Bunny. I'm Kim, and today we'll be doing the mid-year freakout tag. The best book I've read so far in 2021 is definitely The Starless Sea by Erin Morgenstern. This story is one part fantasy tale, one part mythology, and if you are a lover of books and reading, this is a hell of a book. Everything about it is beautiful. The best sequel I've read so far is definitely The Wicked King by Holly Black. That book is so full of subterfuge and deceit and mistrust that you don't know which way to look and you don't know who you can count on, and there's plots within plots, and it's so much scheming. When the end came, it just hit me like a slap in the face. Guys, I missed one. Literally don't even know how I missed it. Question number three, a new release that you haven't read yet, but you want to. And that is definitely One Last Stop. Oh my God, I am so excited about this book. The most anticipated release for the second half of the year. I am super excited for Billy Summers by Stephen King. I don't actually know a lot about this book. I'm kind of biased because I love Stephen King. So I'm gonna grab it and I'm sure it's gonna be fabulous. My biggest disappointment so far this year was for The Love of Books by Graham Tarrant. It had a lot of interesting facts and takeaways, but overall it read like a textbook and it just didn't hold my attention like I thought it would. And that was just really unfortunate. Biggest surprise so far has got to be Later by Stephen King. I have to admit, I judged the book by the cover. I saw the little hard case logo in the corner and it immediately made me think of Colorado Kid, which I wasn't a huge fan of. But then Jess the Book Freak, she did an amazing review on it and she just pushed me over that fence. I read it, I loved it. It was not what I was expecting. Favorite new author, debut or new to me? That's gotta be N.K. Jemisin. I read her trilogy this year and this trilogy blew me away. It was such a beautiful masterpiece of the fantasy genre. Newest fictional crush, gotta say Hatter from Heartless. This iteration of the classic Mad Hatter character is before he's mad, but he's definitely still on his way there. You can just see it in everything he does and he fixates. And everything about this character was intriguing. He was one part nemesis, one part protagonist. Perfect character. Love Hatter. Newest favorite character. Not a crush, just a favorite character. I have to say Nesta from the Court of Thorns and Roses trilogy. She is so full of fire. I know the story centered around her sister, Feyre, but Nesta was the icing on the cake. Every time she was featured in one of these books, I just wanted to know more about her. I am super excited to read her spin-off trilogy. She's great. Such a spitfire. Love her. Do not mess with Nesta. A book that made me cry so far this year was definitely Winter Girls by Laurie Hulse Anderson. Cherry actually reads recommended this book in one of her videos. The book that made me happy this year was Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. Carry On follows the story within the story from her previous book, Fangirls. And the story within the story, of course, is Simon Snow and his magical school and all of his adventures. Most beautiful book I've gotten so far this year is definitely 100 Days of Sunlight. What books do I need to read by the end of this year? So many. I want to read the Witcher series for sure. That's sort of been on the docket for a while. I got them last year, almost a whole year ago now, if not a little bit more. And I've only read the first two in that entire series. I need to finish it. So that is my goal. Favorite book to movie adaptation this year. It's not really a movie adaptation. It was turned into a TV show on Netflix, Shadow and Bone. And I haven't even read the book series yet, but Shadow and Bone was such a great series that I need to read that series now, including Six of Crows, which is sort of weaved into the plot of the Netflix show. At least that's my understanding. I'll have to read it all to get it more cemented in my mind. But that. And that's it. That is the mid-year freakout. One other point I wanted to make was that my goal for the year as a whole was to read 100 books, and I'm at 43 as of this filming. 43, not quite halfway. To be on par, I need to make 50 by the end of the month. So hopefully I can do that. And if I just keep plugging away, I should be able to make it. We'll see. It might be a tight fit. I think last year I was ahead by like 10. This year I'm right on par. So if anything happens life-wise that throws me off, I might not make it. We'll see what happens. All right, that's it for my tag. I wasn't tagged in this video. I came across it and thought it would be a great video to do. It sounded like fun. So I will tag whoever is watching this. If you are watching this right now, tag. You're it. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments. If you decide to do this tag, let me know. What are your thoughts on any of the books that I've mentioned? Do you have an upcoming release for the second half of 2021 that you are dying to read? I'd like to know what it is. All right, book nerds, that's it for me. And as always, happy reading.